So basically, after that 2 year period where you went really hardcore, would you say that you were like completely fluent in the language?
Not completely. So here's the thing. If I was talking with someone one-on-one, yes. But the difficult thing with a second language is when you're talking with a group of people who are all natives. So when they're talking to each other and trying to like get into the conversation, that's where I was still struggling after 2 years. So after 2 years, one-on-one, no problem. I did job interviews in Japanese, no problem. I actually got a job just based on being able to do the interview in Japanese, even though they had a translator. So I got that job, and it was at a kindergarten. I was just a homeroom teacher for this immersion class. So I don't know if you guys know about the... You probably do, but your listeners might not. So the school system in Japan, generally speaking, you have homerooms. So like all the kids in a grade are divided into different homerooms, and the teachers go to each room to teach their subjects, and they don't move from the room, generally speaking, right? And that's true in kindergarten as well, which is from 3 to 5 year olds. So I had my own room, and my kids all... they didn't speak English. I spoke English to them all day, every day. These 4 to 5 year olds. And except for like when they needed discipline and stuff, like you can't discipline a kid who doesn't speak English in English, because they're not going to know what you're talking about. They're just going to laugh in your face and be like, ha, 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 that's funny. So like then I'd have to speak Japanese. But all the other teachers there didn't speak English. So I had to use English every day at work. Japanese every day at work. All the documentation and stuff every day was in Japanese. I had to write reports by hand every single day, like a page of what happened during the day in Japanese. So that's when I really started leveling up, because we'd have meetings like two or three times a week that were all in Japanese, and I actually had to participate and like, you know, give feedback and stuff. So that's when I started being able to speak to other, like to get involved in conversations in groups of Japanese people. And that's when I started to consider myself like really fluent, because I could read, I could write, and I could speak to Japanese groups of people while they were talking to each other. Because that was the hardest part for me before I got that job, was like I felt really, really good. I'd be talking to one person Japanese, and then two other Japanese people would come in and they'd start talking to each other, and I'd just be sitting there like, I know what you're saying and I know what I want to say, but you're already on the next subject. That was really hard in the beginning. But yeah, so I would say where I considered myself fluent was after about 3 years, right?
I see. Yeah, that seems like pretty in line with like a lot of people I interview. Like, it's like the 3 year mark is like a pivotal moment.
That was, yeah, yes.
Yeah.